Hello there, and welcome to Node, the Hard Parts. I'm Will Sentance. I run Codesmith, a coding school based in Los Angeles, New York, and online. And today, we're going to look into Node. In this course, we're going to cover many of the most important features of this incredibly popular and influential technology. This technology is used by companies as wide-ranging as Netflix, Uber, LinkedIn, IBM. We're going to discover how do servers work? What is the nature of HTTP, the request, the response object? We're going to go deep on exactly what happens when we run JavaScript code to control our computer's internal features. This is going to be the crux of what Node does. Then we're going to dive deeper. We're going to explore streams. We're going to explore asynchronicity, the event loop, the callback queues, and the call stack itself. All of this tied together is going to give you the ability to tackle any new feature that emerges in Node and build out performant and effective servers in your teams and in your development projects. So I'm thrilled to have you along for this course, and I look forward to seeing you on the inside. We have in 1, 2, 3 lines of JavaScript built an entire server because in JavaScript, all the black stuff's JavaScript. There's not many words done in black. All the purple stuff is built in Node features. And damn, look at that. It has a function that's going to auto-run. It has auto-insert data arguments. It has auto-inserted arguments that it automatically made. And it threw them into the function that's auto-run. So that we had access to the incoming data from the incoming message and access to the outgoing message to add data to it, the tweets, or in this case, a very boring message, welcome to Twitter, via the object that gets passed in, which has a bunch of functions that when run, here we are, executing the end function, executing it, doing it, is going to give us back access to this message here and send that message back. So this is the absolute essence of Node. And we're going to see again and again and again, there is nothing else in this language. Whenever we use a background computer internal feature, it could be the file system. It could be the open network socket. It could be other features of the computer itself. Every time we're going to use a built-in label that sets up the Node C++ feature that has access to the background feature, we're going to need to add a function that Node will auto-run whenever the background feature gets activity, or if we're getting a file, for example, when the file gets into Node, out of the file system, out of the computer's internals, a function that will auto-run. We're then going to need to design that function such that it's ready to receive incoming data, functions to set outgoing data, ready to receive the auto-created and auto-inserted data that's relevant. In this case, it's the input data or the Sarah Rose's Max request data and a bunch of functions in this case that allow us to access Node again with specific responses to send back to Sarah Rose. All right, people, let's sum it up. Rules for the automatic execution of the JavaScript code of JavaScript code by Node, because by the way, all of this is built by Node with the help of LiveUV. It's not JavaScript. All of these queues and the event loop of triggering it is all Node, not JavaScript. All built in C++. Hold each deferred, I call these deferred, functions that we didn't run ourselves that are going to be auto-run later. They're deferred, delayed to auto-run later, in one of the task queues. When the Node background API, these are actually these C++ features, they're technically known as APIs. Interface is a posh word for any functionality that's not in my language, but in someone else, or not in my world, but in someone else's. I interface with it. When any of the background Node C++ features complete, the auto-run function, don't auto-run them. Queue them up to be auto-runned. Auto-run. Add the function to the call stack. In other words, execute the function, add it to the call stack. We did this with each of them. Only when the call stack is totally empty, have the event loop be checking for this condition to be true. Prioritize functions in the timer queue, technically a min heap, you know, but basically a queue, over the IO queue, over the check queue, it's known as, over the close queue, And because I wasn't sure I was going to tell you about these two, 4, prioritize over all those queues any functions that were delayed by using a promise, which we're not going to touch on today, but is another way of triggering background work, and instead of auto-running a function, auto-inserting data into JavaScript, that auto-runs a function in JavaScript. That function goes in the micro-task queue. But there's two of those. That one goes in B. The number one priority of all that we don't even use is process.nextTick. Any function you pass there, that goes in to the very, very first queue. There we go, people. Those are all the rules of Node.